Welcome back, Tigers. Another video on campaign influence. One of the not so awesome limitations of custom models in campaign influence is only the default model shows in the campaign influence related lists on the opportunity and campaign records. We're going to show you two ways you can show this information to your users right from the opportunity page. Let's hop over to Salesforce and check out how to add these cool features. Here we are in Salesforce and we're on a closed one opportunity that is showing us one campaign influence record for our first touch model. Now in this org, we have four different models set up. If we go to model settings under campaign influence, we can see that we have our primary campaign source model, which is the default model Salesforce comes with. And then we've set up even distribution, first touch and last touch models. Our first touch model is our default model, so that's the reason why we're seeing only one campaign influence record from this opportunity related list. Now, what we want to do is create a button that's going to invoke a report that will allow us to see the campaign influence records from all four of our models in one view. We're going to come over to our reports tab and we're going to create a new report. We're going to use the report type called Campaigns with Influenced Opportunities Customizable Campaign Influence. We're going to group our report based on the model name first, and then based on the campaign name. I'll change the filters to show all campaigns. And then I'm going to add a filter for my opportunity ID. I'm going to leave it blank here. I'll hit apply and then I'll save and run this. Now you will not see any records in the report because our filter is blank here. Next, we're going to go to the opportunity object, go to buttons, links, and actions, and we'll create a new button or link. We'll call this View All Campaign Influence. This will be a detail page button, and then I'll give you this URL in the description below. Now, what we need to do is copy and paste the ID of our report right here. So we'll copy this ID and we'll paste it into our URL and we'll click save. Next, we need to add this to our page layout. If you're using dynamic forms on your Lightning record pages, you'll have to add the button there. We are currently still using buttons on our page layout. We'll go to mobile and Lightning actions and we'll drag and drop our View All Campaign Influence button into this section down here. We'll click save. Then we'll go to an opportunity record and we should be able to see the View All Campaign Influence button. If you can't, go ahead and toggle your display density back and forth and that should refresh your record page. Now, if we click View All Campaign Influence, we should be able to see the influence from all of our models and not just our first touch model. Now, another option that we can use to show the data around campaign influence is a report chart directly on the opportunity page. So let's go back to our report and we'll go to edit. I'm going to do a save as, and this is going to be called Campaign Influence Report Chart. Then I'm going to put this in a shared folder. These have to be in a shared folder if you're going to use a report in a report chart on a Lightning record page. And I have a special folder here called Custom Buttons and Report Links Do Not Modify. And I'll save this. And then we'll have to remove our filter. And then we have to add a report chart. I'm going to go to the settings here. And then I'm going to group this by campaign name and model name. I'll make campaign name first and then model name second. One of the things about a report chart on a Lightning record page is the report chart's gonna follow what your report actually has for the groupings, whichever ones are first, even if your report chart is different. So you'll have to group your report exactly how you want your report chart to show on your opportunity page. So we've got campaign name first and then model name. And then I've got my filter removed. All right, this is all set. We'll save and run this. Then our next step is to add the report chart to the Lightning record page on the opportunity. I'm going to add tabs and I'll add a tab for my reports. And then I'll add my report chart. And then I am choosing my campaign influence report chart up. I'm going to call this campaign influence by model. Filter by will be my opportunity ID. And then we will save that. I'm going to come over to my opportunities. I'll choose this one and then we'll see what our report looks like. So we can see that this particular campaign has influence from three different models. I can't see the values here though, so I'm going to go ahead and update my report chart settings. I'm going to click show values here and that should fix that. Come here and we'll refresh and now I can see the values. Now, of course, you can have more than one report chart here if you just wanted to add two more, one that shows by campaign and then one that shows by model. Now we can do this same exact thing on our campaign page layouts. If we go back to our original report that we were using, campaign influence from op page, we're just going to clone this. And we can call this campaign influence from campaign page. I'll save this in my special report folder. And now the one thing I need to do here is swap out the filter. Instead of opportunity ID, I'm going to look for campaign ID. And then we'll save and run that. Then we'll go to our campaign object. Go to buttons, links, and actions, new button or link. This will be called View All Campaign Influence. This will be a detail page button. We will give you this URL in the description below, and we just need to copy and paste our report link here. We'll save that. We'll go to our campaign page layout and add our button. All right, so now we'll come to a campaign. Let's see which of our campaigns has a lot of stuff. 2024 RiskWise. Let's go to that one. And then we'll click our View All Campaign Influence. And then we can see all of the opportunities for this particular campaign. So it looks like maybe we probably want to group this a little bit differently, right? So we don't need to group by campaign name. It would be more helpful to group by opportunity. Okay, we can see here by model which opportunities are being influenced for this particular campaign. And of course, this method can be used with any object and any Lightning record page within Salesforce. That's it, that's a wrap. Be sure to subscribe to Blue Tiger Academy so you don't miss out on the next video we are working on that will show you how to do advanced campaign influence reporting. Let us know in the comments below if you have any questions or if you'd like to see a video on a different Salesforce topic. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.